Performing their program entitled Acrobats of God, is the guard ready? Black Watch Color Guard, you may begin your performance in competition.
I've spent all my life with dance and being a dancer. It's permitting life to use you in a very intense way. Sometimes it's not pleasant. Sometimes it's fearful. But nonetheless, it's inevitable.
Martha Graham was one of the great American artists of the 20th century. She changed dance. She invented a new language of movement and used it to reveal the passion, the rage, the ecstasy common to human experience. Martha spoke an entirely different language, protesting, stark, and American. Some found her work ugly and hateful. Others found it a revolutionary masterpiece.
Martha's dance, the impulse, starts with a show of effort, and everything started with what she called a contraction, which really was a thrust in the pelvis.
Martha wrote, "You do what you know. You experiment with movement until you find some little secret language that speaks for your body and for your heart." Martha Graham was a woman whose style was larger than life, even when she was off stage, and certainly when she was on.
So they asked me what I thought was the center of the stage. And I said, well, the center of the stage is where I am.
She was glamorous. Who was basically more glamorous? Look at some of those early photographs. She was arrogant and vain. And she wasn't afraid to admit that because she knew that it was true.
Was bothered. She was not in the habit of civilizing herself. Martha could hit, slap, and she was not going to curb her reactions because out of those reactions came dance movement.
And once on stage, she had a tantrum, and Billy simply went up to her and slapped her right across the chops and said, "Get out of this, bitch. Stop your nonsense."
A lot of her personal needs and her work, they related definitely to Martha's interior. And she had this incredible ability to tap that and fearlessly find a movement language to reflect.
Martha's life was her work. There was no other life. She went away to think about dance, to come back to do it. She lived in the studio.
By this point in her life, Martha was severely being crippled by arthritis in her hands and her feet.
Martha was very seriously coming to grips with whether or not she could dance anymore. And she had to have known she was dancing just a little too long, and it wasn't great.
She drank very heavily, and it got worse and worse and worse. And I was told by Gert Macy, who was her manager, said something about Martha. She said, "You better hurry up and see her. She's not going to last long. She's dying of alcoholism."
The hardest thing for her, more than any choreographer, was not to relinquish dancing, but to sit in the wings and watch young people made up to look like her in a dance she loved doing, and she's sitting there, tortured.
I did one rather good in the studio, and she said it would be fine. And the day of my performance in New York, she said, "You must know that this is the worst day of my life."
She could no longer dance. She wanted to die.
Martha wrote, "I know the anonymity of death has no appeal to me. It is the now I must face. What is there for me but to go on? That is life for me."
I received so much from the world, good things and bad things, and I've had people to work with over a period of years whom I treasure. It is my debt. And in a way, it's, as Emily Dickinson said, this is my letter to the world.
Ladies and gentlemen, Black Watch Color Guard from Mount Laurel, New Jersey.